We finally have another gaming capture card that can pass through 1440p 144Hz and capture 1440p 60 and even capture 1080p in 120 frames per second over USB. This is the first non-Magewell USB option that we've had since the Live Gamer Ultra dropped in 2017, and from a company you wouldn't really expect. This video is sponsored by Nerd or Die. I'm EposVox, the Stream Professor, and I'm on a quest to review just about every capture card in existence. I've reviewed hundreds at this point, testing them for gaming, teaching, recording, streaming, retro games, and more. If you want to master your tech and make better content, hit the subscribe and notification buttons so you can stay informed. This slick little capture card right here is the ASUS TUF CU4K30. Yes, a capture card from ASUS, and it's actually pretty solid. Physically, this capture card is slim and feels built really well. There's a bit of that gamer aesthetic that ASUS's TUF line of devices tends to use, but it's not egregious. It's metal, small, and the ports are where they should be. Data and video in the back, audio in the front. The CU4K30 features HDMI 2.0 input and real-time pass-through, as well as USB Type-C port on the back. On the front, you get a 4-pole 3.5mm headset connection and a pass-through port to connect to your game controller. If you're playing on console, you can pass your controller audio through to capture voice chat and still capture your headset microphone. You can still use the headset jack to hear the sound coming through the capture card and to capture your headset mic alongside your game sound, however, even when you're using HDMI audio, which is really handy. Four small rubber feet corner the bottom of the device to keep it from slipping. As mentioned, this card passes through HDMI 2.0. This supports 4K 60 pass-through, 4K 30 capture, 1440p up to 144Hz pass-through for 1440p capture, and 1080p up to 240Hz pass-through for up to 120fps capture. Plus, you can capture 1080p 120 from 1440p 120 or 144Hz as well. 1080p 60fps can be captured from 4K 60 sources as well, of course. HDR is supported for pass-through, and the footage is automatically tone-mapped to SDR for all captures, which is handy. The USB-C connectivity is touted as being USB 3.2, but don't let that scare you off. As far as I've been able to tell, this still is using 5 gigabits per second connectivity. This is frustrating, because I feel the card would have benefited from a 10 gigabit per second optional use case. This card supports uncompressed video at all formats, with NV12 being the primary mode for 4K 30, 1440p 60, and 1080p 120. But YUY2 is also usable at 1080p 60 and lower as well. However, YUI2 is also exposed for 1440p 60, which USB TreeView is even saying it's possible, but it's just not. I only get 45 to 52fps in YUI2 at 1440p no matter what I try. I've tried different PCs, different ports, even bought fancy Thunderbolt 3 cables to use on my 20 gigabit per second USB 3.2 ports. Nothing. There are duplicated frames in the capture on this mode, and even Virtual Dub detects that it's only pulling about 50fps from this card in the YUI2 mode as well. It's really weird. ASUS was kind enough to send out a second sample of this card for me to verify that it just wasn't an issue, you know, with this one unit, but nope, same trouble. So if you see any frame hiccups in capture in this video, I was probably using YUI2 at 1440p for that capture. NV12 is silky smooth. Also, to get a smooth 120fps from this card at 1080p, you will probably need the firmware update available on ASUS's website. The 120fps mode is super key here, on top of 1440p support. There is basically only one other affordable capture card that can do 1440p 144Hz pass-through and 1440p 60 capture and 120fps 1080p capture over USB, and that would be the AVerMedia Live Gamer Ultra, which came out 4 years ago now. So it's finally great to see more options in this space, and the audio connections give the CU4K30 an advantage over the Live Gamer Ultra anyway. Measuring the latency of video input to the capture card being drawn to OBS Studio's preview, we're looking at about 64 milliseconds of input latency. For a USB card, this is great and means you won't have much issue syncing up your audio, but as usual, I wouldn't recommend trying to play from the OBS preview. Use passthrough. This capture card runs with a UVC driver. This means it's plug and play. It even works in Linux. It should theoretically work in Mac as well, but I could not get my M1 Mac Mini to even power the device at all for some reason. This also means that it shows up as a webcam to Windows, allowing it to work in video calling apps like Discord and Zoom, and can easily be captured in the Windows 10 camera app as well. This also means that it would be a useful capture card for pairing with a high quality camera over HDMI, especially with that 4K 30 capture capability. Headset and controller connectivity give this capture card a usability boost over many capture cards on the market. In the box, you get a decently long 4-pole 3.5mm cable to connect your controller to the capture your game sound and or party chat sound, and then you can connect your headset to the headset jack. If you don't have a 4-pole in for your headset, adapters are super cheap. This allows you to capture sound from HDMI and 3.5mm at the same time, plus you can capture your headset mic alongside everything else. Great for console streamers. While the inputs don't show up as different audio devices in Windows like the Ripsaw HD, ASUS does provide an audio controller app, which allows you to control the audio levels and balance between HDMI or controller and your headset mic, as well as adjust your headphone volume. This shows up as one audio device in your streaming program. While there's an OBS certified sticker on the box like the EVGA XR1, you currently still need to manually specify the audio device and choose the capture card's audio for audio to show up. Not a huge deal, just needed to note that. The CU4K30 seems like a decent but not perfect solution for retro captures, though a crucial part of my test is missing at the moment. 480p from the RetroTINK 2X works great even in YUI2, as does 1080p and 1200p modes from the RetroTINK 5X. However, 1440p 6X from the RetroTINK 5X does not work, unfortunately. Ouch. I cannot currently test the OSSC modes like I usually do, as mine appears to have just died. F's in chat, I've ordered a new one. Nerd or Die has everything you need for a top tier, high production value stream, and their graphics packs are like no other. The new Boosted Alerts pack helps really just kind of encourage viewers to get a sub or tip train going, and they have full packages to match any style. Mine, yours, your friends, doesn't matter. Plus, each pack comes with an instant setup script for OBS Studio, Streamlabs OBS, and Stream Elements. Check them out today at eposvox.gg/nerdordie and save 15% at checkout with coupon code EposVox. For $210 new, the ASUS TUF CU4K30 is a pretty compelling offer. It's effectively one of two USB capture cards on the market within a game streaming budget, meaning under the $400+ price point of the Magewell option, that can do 144Hz 1440p pass-through and 1440p 60 capture and 1080p 120 capture. While it can't capture HDR video like Avermedia's Live Gamer Ultra, it still tone maps it, which is fine for the majority of would-be users, and the audio capabilities are a huge benefit over the Live Gamer Ultra 2. I'm disappointed that the 1440p YUI2 mode isn't working properly, but in reality, that's not a huge loss here, and the Live Gamer Ultra can only do YUI2 at 50fps at 1440p as well. They just specify that. The EVGA XR1 can be had for half the price of the TUF CU4K30, and it does 1440p pass-through if you disable the capture card for the advanced pass-through mode, but for normal capture and play, you don't have any of those PC formats, high frame rates, or 1440p supported, so this is definitely a better value if you plan on doing dual PC streaming as well. The card remains stable after firmware updates, didn't get too hot, and is super easy to use, with the only program needed being the audio controller app, if you're even using the analog inputs at all, and that doesn't even require installing. It's surprising to see a company that doesn't specialize in capture cards come out swinging with something so solid, but I am impressed. Let's just hope we start seeing some HDMI 2.1 pass-through options coming within the next 9 to 12 months now. Product links will be in the description down below. As always, hit the like button and subscribe for more tech education. Join us on Discord at discord.gg/eposvox for free assets and downloads. I just put up a glitch TrackMac transition pack for OBS and to help set up your stream. Remember, be kind, rewind.